What's up guys, my name is Arina and welcome back to my channel where I review everything tech. I actually didn't plan to make this video, but about a week ago one of my elderly family members asked me to find a fitness tracker for him. He had three main demands: it had to track activities, measure heart rate and be, well, cheap. And I picked this one. This is Mi Smart Band 4 by Xiaomi, or as they officially call themselves, Xiaomi. It cost me just $35, and just before I bought it, I was really curious about what I can possibly get from a fitness tracker for $35. Spoiler alert, this thing turned out to be so much better than I expected, but let me start from the beginning. First, let's get back to that unboxing moment. In the box, you get the fitness tracker itself with the one size band, a user manual in so many languages, and a USB charger. When I put it on for the first time, the first thing that struck me was how lightweight this thing is. I literally forget that this fitness tracker is on my wrist. For a person who wears an Apple Watch from time to time, this difference in weight is really striking. And I think one of the best things about this fitness tracker is a lightweight and minimalistic design. The band is very soft, so it feels comfortable when I have it on. When it comes to the Mi bands, you don't have size options, so the max circumference of this band is about 8 inches, while the smallest one you can make it is about 5.5 inches, which is my case here. I have very thin wrists, so it's slightly loose on my wrist, but I like it this way, it feels comfortable, not too tight. To set it up, you need to download the Mi Fit app and create an account. The first thing I would recommend you is to adjust the brightness to your comfortable level and set the screen timeout, because by default the display shuts off very quickly, so a slightly longer screen on time would really help you get to know your new gadget faster. So you just go to More, Settings, Brightness, Screen Timeout. By the way, this is an AMOLED display. It's really bright, especially when you set it to the max brightness. When you look at the display from an angle, it doesn't look washed out, and I also haven't experienced any problems with screen visibility outdoors. It's important to note that you don't have the always-on display feature on this device, so the display on the Mi Band 4 shuts off after several seconds. However, you can enable this option called Lift Wrist View Info so that the display turns on when you lift your wrist. By default, this option was disabled. You get 6 workout modes on the Mi Band 4: running, treadmill, cycling, walking, freestyle for any kind of workouts in the gym or at home, and pool swimming. And yes, this thing is water resistant. You can wear it in the swimming pool and in the shower. However, it cannot be used in a sauna or while scuba diving. Most of the time, I've been using the walking and the freestyle mode on this fitness tracker. If you want to see the routes of your walks or runs on the map, you should first open the Mi Fit app to sync and have your phone by your side during the workout, since there is no built-in GPS in this fitness tracker. So you can see different metrics while working out, depending on the workout: the time of your workout, calories burned, heart rate, distance, steps, or speed if it's cycling. And by the way, you can stop or pause your workout by pressing and holding the home button. And you can also see more details of your workouts in the Mi Fit app afterwards. As I previously said, one of the main reasons to buy this fitness tracker was the ability to measure heart rate. With the Mi Band 4, you can monitor your heart rate throughout the day automatically. However, you need to manually enable this feature since it's turned off by default. Also, you can enable the heart rate alert, so if your heart rate suddenly goes up while you're inactive, the band will start vibrating. Since the heart rate feature was one of the key reasons to buy this fitness tracker, I was wondering if I could really trust the heart rate results I get from the smart band. So I decided to do a quick test and compare the data from the Mi Band 4 with the data from a blood pressure monitor, which I think I tend to trust. As you can see, I got really similar results, so I guess this smart band is quite reliable. However, keep it in mind that for more accurate results, your band should be fastened properly. It should not be loose on your wrist. Notifications are another feature you can use on the Mi Band 4, so you will receive notifications from the apps you want, get event reminders, text, emails, etc. Also, you can get incoming call alerts, however, you cannot answer a call, you can only decline it. I'm personally not a fan of reading all the notifications on this fitness tracker because the shape of the display makes the text spread out all the way down, so I personally find it hard to read. Also, you cannot see the emojis, instead you get these weird symbols. So for me it just works this way, I see that I get a text, I know who sent it, and then I'll just read it on my phone later. But overall, I think it's good to have notifications anyway. When it comes to other features on the Mi Band 4, you can also check on the weather, you can turn on Do Not Disturb mode, you can set an alarm, control your music, stopwatch, timer, you can also find your phone, and when it comes to the band displays, you can choose from a variety of watch faces in the Mi Fit app, and you can also find more in some third-party apps. With the Mi Band 4, you can track your sleep. It'll show you some details about the quality of your sleep, such as how many hours you spent in a deep sleep and light sleep. I'm personally not a fan of wearing any bands when I go to bed, even though this one is very comfortable to wear. But I was curious to test it out, and that's actually pretty interesting and could be helpful for you if this is something you're looking for in a fitness band. When it comes to the Mi Fit app, it seems a little over the place to me. I think the Fitbit app is one of the best in terms of simplicity. But anyway, I think you'll have no problem getting used to it. Now let's talk about the battery of this device. In order to charge it, you need to pop the fitness tracker out of the band first and connect it to the charger. Pay attention to these two connectors, they should match. It took me about 2 hours to fully charge the Mi Band 4. Not bad, considering the fact that the battery life of this fitness tracker is incredible. Xiaomi claims that you get up to 20 days of battery life. I've been using this fitness tracker for about a week now after the last charge, and it's 70%. I noticed that the workouts are the most battery draining. I do about 3 workouts a week. But if you plan to use this band mostly for step counting, I think you'll have to charge it like once a month. So guys, I definitely recommend you this fitness tracker if you're looking for something lightweight, simple, and not expensive. By the way, many years ago I was using the Mi Band 1, which didn't even have a display. I remember it could only count steps and calories, but even then it could already measure the heart rate. So doing this review was kinda nostalgic for me, and it's really good to see the Mi Band progress through these years. Like I said in the beginning, I was on a very tight budget, so my initial choices of the Fitbit Inspire HR as well as the Samsung Galaxy Fit just didn't make the cut. But overall, for $35, I must say I'm really happy with this fitness tracker. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys, and see you in the next one!